Let me use this video to summarize now all of our boundary conditions. Let me draw the rectangle. So this is our radial direction, cosine, and this is our angular-polar angle direction. This is theta sub j. Cosine variable goes from 0 to its maximum value. There are n grid points in cosine, so this goes to cosine sub n. The theta variable goes from 0 on the midline behind the cylinder to pi on the midline in front of the cylinder. Okay, so what are the boundary conditions? So when theta equals 0, this is on the midline. We know that the stream function and the vorticity are 0 on the midline. So this boundary condition on this side of the rectangle would be psi. So we have the first grid point in theta and all the grid points in cosine. So that means I 1, and that's supposed to be 0, but also true for the vorticity. So the vorticity I 1 is also 0. So this is the midline behind the cylinder. The top side of the rectangle is the midline in front of the cylinder. And again, the fields are 0. So this is psi I. And then we have m points in the theta direction. So this is psi I m equals omega I m, also equal to 0. So those are the two midlines of the flow. Okay, what about this left side of the rectangle? This corresponds to cosine equal to 0. So this is the cylinder boundary condition, the cylinder boundary condition. So we know that the stream function is 0 on the cylinder. So that means the stream function on the cylinder means the first grid point for all angle j has to be 0. Okay. What about the vorticity on the cylinder? That was this complicated boundary condition which we derived. So we have the vorticity on the cylinder, 1, j, is equal to 1 over 2 times h squared, so h is the grid spacing, times the stream function 2 points away from the cylinder, minus 8 times the stream function 1 point away from the cylinder. So this is the most sophisticated boundary condition, which generates vorticity on the cylinder by computing the difference between these stream functions, 1 and 2 grid points away from the cylinder. You have a division by h squared here, so h is very small, so that better be balanced with psi being relatively small. We know psi is 0 on the cylinder. So this is a crucial boundary condition. Okay, finally, on the right side of the rectangle, this is the maximum value of cosine. So we're the farthest distance away from the cylinder. That's the free stream boundary condition. So the free stream boundary condition on the stream function will be psi n, comma j, because we're at the last grid point. And the free stream boundary condition is e to the psi n times sine theta j. So it depends on the polar angle, but we're at the farthest distance away from the cylinder. And we take the simple boundary condition on the vorticity in the free stream to be 0. Okay, so these are all of the boundary conditions. We have a boundary condition on the stream function and the vorticity. On the midline of the flow, right behind the flow, in front of the flow, and on the cylinder, and in the free stream. this is what you need to implement in your code. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.